What up, my beauty tubies? Welcome to another draft here on my YouTube's channel. Thanks for hitting that like and subscribe button. Click that little bell icon. You know the shindig. If you haven't already, shame on you. Let's jump into the draft. We have a Jyn Gataxias, baby. Yeah. Have not had this card very frequently at all. I think maybe two or three times tops. And I think two of the three times might have been in sealed. So nice little pickup here. It's a Praetor. You know it's going to be good. 7 mana, 5-5, and then, yeah, lots of words. I'll let you read that. But basically, it is kind of hard to deal with once you've resolved it. By this point in the game, your opponent generally doesn't have that many cards in their hand. And so even if they do have a removal spell, oftentimes they're going to have to wait until they find another card that can trigger this. So yeah, nice pickup here. Passing a couple of other good cards we didn't really go over, but Jyn Gataxias is the slam dunk for sure. And so we really want to just go into a long game with this card, right? So we want to get ways to help us get to the long game or ramp us there faster. So things like the Greater Tanuki, great pickup. Thing of Shigeki, pretty good pickup. Thornwood Falls, good pickup. The White Shrine would be a decent pickup as well. I mean, this is probably the best card in the pack. There's like a Twisted Embrace here, some other good cards, but I mean, y'all know me. I like doing the 3, 4, 5 color rampy control decks in this format. And yeah, don't get me wrong, the control or the aggro decks are good, but I prefer doing the other things. So what am I gonna take here? I mean, I'm kind of eyeing this Thornwood Falls, honestly. I think I dig it. Let's just take the falls and move on. As we get a third pick, probably a Modern Age. This is another card that's been super impressive. I think people are coming around to how good this card is. It just smooths out your early game draws, and it turns into a relevant creature later on as well. So easy Modern Age here for me. Passing a Hacker. And not too much else. So easy choice. Fourth pick, this looks like a Geothermal Kami to me, over the Careful Cultivation. Another card that people are coming around to, just does way too much work, both offensively, defensively, and value-wise, so pretty easy Geothermal Kami. We're passing the Careful Cultivation, we're passing the Guidebot. That is a-okay by me. Another pretty good pack here. I'm not the biggest fan of Azusa's Many Journeys, but I think it is playable enough. Obviously it doesn't do anything if you're not going to utilize the excess lands with the first trigger, that is to say. The second trigger is nice, the third trigger is nice. But I think that's going to be my choice here. Like, I could take the Terrarium or the Preserver, certainly. But I think this just does enough to be good. I think. Now I'm second guessing myself and thinking maybe I just want to take the Terrarium because I know I'm going to end up in like four color soup anyways. Yeah, let's do that. Into a Season of Renewal, very, very easy. I don't know why. I just don't think the Orochi Merge Keeper is all that great. Like, usually the modified decks are red-green, and in red-green you don't really need the extra mana. And so, you know, if you're going to have a 2-mana 1-1 that makes a green, you would rather just have Careful Cultivation, which is a 1-1 that makes a green for 2 mana, but it's instant speed. It's also an enchantment. It also can be an aura if you need to. So anyways, in this format, people are beginning to realize the value of cards like the Modern Age, the Geothermal Kami, the Season of Renewal, so I think it's important to pick it up early. Wow. I don't think people are maybe necessarily paying attention to how good Containment Construct is. This is another one that's just really, really good, especially if you can get some Modern Ages with it. Just becomes into a huge, or turns into a huge card advantage engine. Like, anytime I go turn 2 Construct, turn 3 Modern Age, I feel like I can't lose. Another solid pack here. We have the choice between Puzzle Maker and Repel the Vial. I mean, the quote-unquote safe pick is just taking the Puzzle Maker. It's on color and it does block a lot of stuff, but Repel is quite good. I think I'm okay sticking with the blue and green for now. I mean, it's very possible I don't even end up splashing, That was pick 8. I don't quite recall what was in our opening pack with the Jin Gataxius. Oh, okay. Network Terminal and Rugged Highlands. So, surprisingly, two good pickups here. Let's take the Terminal. It's just fantastic with the Construct and really good with the Puzzle Maker as well. But the Highlands would be another decent pickup. I do remember next pack having, what, the Snake and the Tanuki? I'm not sure either of those would wheel, but if we do wheel either... Oh. Hello? These were like two of the three best cards in the pack, maybe? Oh, wait, this was the pack that also had White Shrine, but still, okay. Right, well, I'm going to take the Tanuki, I guess, but I think both of these cards are fantastic. The Fang of Shigeki just does so much work as a one-drop. Like, they don't want to attack their better, larger creatures into it. It's very easy to bounce with the Kami and whatnot. And yeah, Mnemonic Sphere, another card that's really solid with the Construct. I don't normally like running this card, because I think there are better ways to get value. But, looks okay here. This might be the most solid, like, blue-green start I've ever had. I don't tend to run the Trespassers, but it's not a bad card. It does give you a lot of value, but I think we're going to probably pass on that. Alright, some wheels here. Almost certainly not going to play either of those. I mean, the best part about all of this is that we have good fixing, too. I have the Tanuki, I have the Falls, I have the Terminal, I have the Terrarium, so... If I, you know... If we open some good white, black, or red card, it's just very easy to take it. Yeah, I think here... I think you all know what I'm taking. It ain't Soul Transfer, but it is a black card. The Life of Toshiro. This one's a little bit awkward. Splashing it is not as good as just being black in the main. But I am a fool for this one, and I will certainly splash it. Easy money. I mean, you don't need it on turn two to be good. In fact, oftentimes you're waiting a little bit later to get some value. And yeah, again, we already have good fixing. Like, given the fact that Tanuki wheeled out of our first pack, or pack one, we could even wheel it here again. So very, very good. Only thing we're missing is like a Behold the Unspeakable, and then I would call this deck unbeatable. Don't need any other cards. Just pick up Behold the Unspeakable. Can't lose. I guess we're a little... Oh, wait. Wait. There's a Fable of the Mirror Breaker here, too. Oh, man. This is another insane card. Oh, it's so splashable, too. Damn. Well, I'm not going to wheel either of these. I do think Fable is a better card than the Behold the Unspeakable, but I find Behold the Unspeakable more fun, if that makes sense. It's just so demoralizing, and plus... You get to draw a bunch of cards and whatnot. Alright, I'm just gonna take the Behold here. The Fable, again, I think it is a slightly better card. Both are insane. But I'm just gonna take the Behold. Into this pack, pick 3. I think I might just go with Tranquil Cove here. Tales of Master Sashiro and the Harmonious Emergence are both pretty good. And Jukai Trainee does a good job of just blocking like a lot of early crap, but I often end up splashing like an Imperial Oath or, you know, some Arrest or something, so I think the land is easy the right choice. Grove Archer here over the Long Reach of Night. This has been another all-star card in the format. Just does so much work. You play this on turn 2, and if they don't have a removal spell, it basically blocks everything. What we want to wheel here is actually the Sentinel, because this is going to turn into a good grindy deck, so I think Sentinel is on our list of things that we want to pick up. Pick 5 is going to be garbage here. I guess I have some number of artifacts. We can just take the automated, perhaps. Yeah, it's not a terrible choice. Not a great choice, but good enough. Yeah, a few recovery units going around, but they don't really do anything for us. Nor do any of these blue cards. If we get like a Kappa Tech Wrecker, running the recovery unit could be maybe worth it. But I'm not getting hopes up on that one. Okay, decent pack here. No hits yet for the Shrine Steward. At least I don't think so, right? No. But I usually end up with some number of Arrest or Tamiyo's Completion. So it's not a bad pickup. Other good pickups. Roadside Reliquary looks pretty good here. Cliffs would be okay. Second Terminal would be okay. I think I'm going to go for the Steward and plan on getting the upside of just picking up a couple of random auras. Get a Tamiyo Safekeeping here. I always do like running one of these in my green decks. It's just so efficient. Puzzle Maker's good. Getting the Puzzle Maker on the wheel would have made the second terminal a lot better, but that's fine. Okay, did not wield. I think it was one of those packs. It was either that last pack or this pack that had the Tanuki. We didn't get it back. Don't think we're playing the Guardians of Oboro. Alright, last few pickups. Actually, the Kami of Terrible Secrets isn't bad. Oh yeah, the Kami of Terrible Secrets is a really good 4-drop filler card, too. There's the Raito Sentinel. Good, good, good. Yeah, this is looking like a nice one. Looking like a real nice one. Fixing-wise, we didn't really get much out of this pack. But we didn't really need it, I guess. So hoping to get Imperial Oath, a Completion, or two. I mean, a lot of good cards, but common-wise, that's what I'm looking for. Completion and some other cards. Yeah, kind of a sad open Blade of the Oni. It's a good card, but we're not taking it here. Just doesn't fit in this style of deck. It might seem a little bit weird, but I think I want to take the Twin Shot Sniper. Either that or the Spirited Companion. Both pretty good. What's my fixing for Sniper right now? I have the Terminal and the Terrarium. I didn't take that Swiftwater Cliffs, which would have been good. I guess we have the Tanuki as well, if I run some mountains. Sniper versus Dog. Let's take the Sniper. It might look weird, but it's an easy splash. As we pick up, there it is. Okay, Grafted Growth. And that gives us at least one target now for our Shrine Steward. It's also a good piece of fixing. As we pass a Repel the Vial, no big deal. Wow, 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 wow. Spinning Wheel Kick or Kappa Tech Wrecker. Man, man, man. Both are so good. I think Kappa is just a little bit too good. We have double Puzzle Maker right now and the Modern Age. Both of those can get in reasonably well because of the evasion. But yeah, I mean, I want a lot of these cards in this pack. I want the Kappa, I want the Wheel Kick, I want the Tanuki, the Commune, maybe even the Koi and the Rebuke, but ugh. Good stuff. Another Grafted Growth here is not awful. That would give us two hits with the Shrine Steward, and though they're not great hits, I don't really want to ever run Shrine Steward with only one target. But was hoping for a Tamiyo's Completion more than another one of those. We can take the fish now if we want to, since Scoured Barrens doesn't do anything. That's too bad. Decoy is probably not awful. Yeah, fish is fine. Ah, there's the Imperial Oath. Nice. Yeah, I mean, I don't think the deserted or twisted Baron. What's it called? No, Scoured Barrens. Scoured Barrens was not a high dual land pickup anyways because it would be double off color. But yeah, these decks always want one. Wow, 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 wow. What are people doing? Seventh pick Blossom Prancer and then a Blossoming Sands. I have to take Prancer here. Oh, this hurts. This hurts a lot. I mean, it doesn't hurt because this is great, but the land was super good too. Obviously. We'll take the cuff, but we don't need it. The double puzzle makers are just better. Last few pickups. I don't expect us to wheel anything good. So I guess my biggest issue with this deck is our lack of removal. Somehow didn't see a single Tamiyo's completion. I don't think we saw an Intercessor's Arrest as we wheel in a Tanuki, baby. Let's go. Alright, so we can probably cut the automated. I don't think we need the Sentinel anymore. Still need to cut like two cards. What are we cutting? I think the sphere is probably a cut. I guess I could get away with 16 lands, but these decks always want to hit their land drops, so I'm just going to play it safe and run 17. Nothing, nothing, nothing here. Maybe we get really lucky and pick up one of the lands. Doesn't look like it. Good stuff. I'm debating the Sentinel. I think the Sentinel's a lot more playable than people give it credit for, but it's not like something really important. And I guess we actually... I guess because we don't really have much removal, maybe it's not as good. If that makes sense. Because what's my removal right now? Sniper, Kappa, kind of, Grove Archer, kind of, Life of Toshiro, kind of. Kind of regretting, speaking of kind of, regretting passing those. Repel the Vials. I feel like Koi might be our cut. Has the least amount of synergy, I think. Damn. Yeah, with the Tamiyo's completion or two, I think this deck would be very, very good. As it stands, I think it's solid. The power level's there. But the removal is certainly lacking. All right, that gives us 8 green sources, 7 blue sources, 2 white, a black, and a red. I mean, we don't even really need... no, we do. Yeah, we want one of each basic with the double Tanuki and the, where is it? The, Terrarium. Good deck. Yeah, I think it's definitely worth splashing for Sniper. Definitely worth splashing these black cards. We have a lot of fixing. We have double Grafted, double Tanuki, Terrarium, the Terminal. This might even be too much mana, but we do have ways of scrying and looting stuff away, so... We also want to get to big manas anyways. I'm really debating running this Sentinel. But I guess we'll go without it. Alright. Oh, we are, what, rank 9 right now? I peaked at number 1 this morning. On stream. Then we had a 3-3 or something and went back down. So let's try to regain some of that lost rank. And like I mentioned last time, this kind of unfortunate, but because we're so early to hit Mythic, the match times The pairing times are gonna creep up to 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minutes, you know. We'll see. I do want to note that I have been getting some amount of practice in for the upcoming champs. The Neon Dynasty Championships that'll be happening on the 12th and 13th of March. So just over a week from when I'm recording this. I'm probably submitting pretty standard decks. Yeah, it's Historic and Alchemy. And I just really haven't had the urge to record any of them, the constructed decks for the YouTube channel. Maybe after I've submitted the decks on this coming Sunday, I'll do a couple videos, but enjoying the draft format, so keep doing that, huh? On the play here, hand looks fantastic. Don't have a green, but that doesn't matter. We don't even have any green cards in our hand. We have Castable Life of Toshiro and Puzzle Maker, so snap that baby up. Oh! Is that a juicy treat for me? Dang, opponent with a constructed start. Turn one Boseiju plus Generous Visitor over there. Alright, would love to find a forest off the top next turn. Now remember, the Life of Toshiro is going to help me cast this Imperial Oath too, so come on, forest. No complaints about a land. Ooh. Ah, that's too good to pass up. It sucks, but it's gotta be correct. I guess we'll just trade. That means I'm not gonna cast the Oath, but I wouldn't be drawing a land anyways for Oath, so this is okay. I'm gonna go ahead and attack again. I'm not gonna loot with the terminal. And yeah, we'll just keep any land. Terminal, pass. We can hold up the sniper if they try to get cute with something. And then we can play anything but our Tanuki next turn. Sure. Hopefully they just gain 4 life. That'd be fantastic. They found a Kami. Alright. So now the question is, do I want to sniper their road captain before they can bounce it? Probably not. I think we just want to slam our Oath here. And yeah, I think it makes sense to draw the forest and then the season. We're not casting the season next turn, so we don't need to top it immediately. Whoa. This is bold. Alright, well I think I'm going to leave their Prancer and go like this. Clearly they have something. And if they kill my Puzzle Maker, then they only get to eat a 2-2, so it's not a huge deal. Oh, interesting. Already dead or something? Oh, they just wanted to... Huh. Well, now our game plan is just 100% we're going to Twin Shot Sniper the Gloom Shrieker since they have the Geothermal in their hand. We don't want them to be able to buy that back. Interesting play there. Oh, did I miss an attack with my... I missed an attack with my 2-2. Whoopsies. Oh, we have to hope they don't have a green source there. Let's draw the season. What's the best play? See, this is where not having any removal sucks, because if our opponent just plays something like Hidetsugu, we're going to have a hard time with it, you know? Could just play the Tanuki, could just run out the Behold. I guess let's scry and loot here first and decide what we want to do. I guess we're gonna go draw towards our, Ataxius. Alright, so they're gonna Kami, bounce their raid, replay it, yeah. Both of those are great. Kami lets us rebuy the Behold for value. Construct with our Puzzle Maker's insane. Yeah, we'll go ahead and get a Scry loot in. Let's go ahead and play out the Geothermal and bounce our Behold this turn. Value go burp 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 burp. Alright, let's put this here. We'll double block there. Whatever, that's fine by me. We are grinding them out, so we don't care trading like this. Continuously bouncing the raids, funny. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 mana. Let's go ahead and run out the Kami. Nope, we don't have an enchantment anymore, so let's run out the Behold first. Then we play out the Kami. Great. And we do get to a poke in for one. Certainly a good enough keep. Sure, don't care about that. Terrarium and a Grafted Growth. I think keeping the Grafted Growth is good. We have so many things to do with our mana. Okay, now what? Too many good plays. I think we're gonna go season back our Life of Toshiro plus our Geothermal. And then we're gonna Life of Toshiro on their Fang of Shigeki is the plan. Guess I might as well get a free loot in first. No, that's too much mana. I gotta be a little bit careful. They do have a lot of pressure here. Yeah, so maybe we just Life of Toshiro, their Fang. They sack it to hit Itsugu. Grafted growth here. Pump up our puzzle maker so it can block and attack more effectively. And just pass with safekeeping open. I guess maybe I just let the behold flip into a fat flyer. We have the safekeeping to protect it. And we're already getting infinite value anyways with like terminal and construct and puzzle maker. And I mean, look at my hand. In fact, I don't even think I need this construct anymore if I don't want to. Yeah, let's go ahead and just trade everything off. What are they gonna do? I mean, they could have their own season of renewal, but I don't think that's good enough. Gain life here. Let's go look for Gataxius. It's not Gataxius. Two, three, four, five mana. Let's attack for two. Scry. Modern Age. Pass. They did top something the other turn, so... maybe it's like a spinning wheel kick or something. Another Gloom Shrieker, sure. Do they have land for Geothermal? Oh, it's a tap land though. Alright, well now we get to... maybe they made a slight mistake here. We get to... Geothermal Kami back our Life of Toshiro. And then Life of Toshiro the Gloom Shrieker before they can start that loop back. There's Gataxius, good. They're not blocking either, huh? Alright, take 12. Yeah. So they can sack it and scry too, but whatever. They didn't. Alright, Kappa then pass. Kind of funny, I still haven't even played out any of these Tanukis. Sure. And this game's pretty over though. Chaining Blossom Prancers is good. It ain't good enough, my friend. get to actually just smash in with everything here. Oh, do we need the... Oh, we know quite a bit of our library. So, if I play out a spell from my hand, my Vision of the Unspeakable is going to die. So this is a decent block from them. Oh, well, I guess we know the cards in their hand. I guess we'll save it. And they only have green and black, so I don't have to worry about them having like a farewell. So we'll just slam the Jin Gataxius and say, hey, your move. Not much removal, but goddamn is my value high. Aww, they top decked a Twisted Embrace? Boo. They dead on board though? 4, 5, 6, yeah, they're dead on board. Uh-oh, is this gonna be like yesterday's video? Yesterday's video was like 2 hours long. I don't know how long that game took, but it was a while. See, just imagine if I had like one or two Tamiyo's completions that I could go tutor off of the Shrine Steward or something, you know, lock down their blossoms. Wouldn't even have to worry. That is how we do, though, baby. Don't mind me, just queuing up. He went up and waited. Well, maybe I'll just cut this out. All right. All right, here we are for round game two, I guess. On the play, yuh-oh. Where's my fixing? There's my fixing. Ooh, what are we pitching here? Oh, man. I guess I'm gonna pitch the sniper, because we're kind of skipping turn four if I go Grafted Growth. Right, we can go Grafted Growth into Behold, perhaps. I think that makes sense. They play a Jukai Trainee. Please don't have a Fade into Antiquity. Well, if you do, I guess it's better they do it on my Grafted than on my Behold. Aha! Touché. We are drawing too many lands now. Well, if I could go back in time, I would put a forest on the bottom instead of that sniper. I'll say that. Turn 4 Behold the Unspeakable into turn 5 Imperial Oath is pretty darn good, though. Assuming they don't have a way to interact with the Behold. That's why green decks are always scary. Could just fade into Antiquity me. O-Ring? O-Ring the Behold, maybe? Whoa, Goro Goro on the splash. Okay. And yeah, they can make a dragon next turn too. Yikes. I'm gonna keep the safekeeping, I think. Oh? Okay. Attack with the trainee and make a dragon is what I'm guessing is going to happen here. Yep. It is not the worst case scenario, thankfully. Although it's not going to be easy to race or whatever. And they have another way to modify in the form of that Terrarium. It's a cool looking dragon. Dragon spirit. Oh, it's got hands. What the heck? So this stops them from what? Artifacts, instants, and sorceries, but not enchantments indeed. Oh man, keeping that sniper would have already won the game. We would have sniped the Goro Goro. Might have an interesting one on our hands. Sure. Yeah, they're just gonna race. I like it. That's a good draw. That is a very good draw. Two, four, six, seven, eight. You know, I'm not gonna lie, I kind of forgot. I kind of forgot that that card copied my cards. That's pretty funny. Okay. And that should be game. All right. I totally forgot Jin Kataxius copied things. Yeah. In fact, did I build my deck correctly knowing that Gataxius copies? Should I actually be running like Mnemonic Sphere? No, because the Sphere comes down early. It's just like the Sentinel that maybe I want. That's hilarious. Alright, anyway. GG, go next. Oh, an insta match. Nice. Nice, nice. Oh man, I played this person like 3 times on stream today. That is a pretty good looking hand. Basically our best turn 2 play right there, the Grove Archer. Planes to lead. I don't mind that, I guess. Ah, aggro deck. So that they either just drew the mountain or they just drew the battery. Either way, this is so good versus the aggressive decks. And if they don't kill my Grove Archer this turn, we're gonna Grafted Growth on top of it. So it gets out of flare range. No, no, no. So I said I get out of the flare range. Hello? Very rude. Actually, our hand is basically crafted to beat aggressive decks. Blossom Prancer, Behold, and Imperial Oath are some like unbeatable cards for red-white aggro. Like, I'm just gonna go Blossom Prancer into Oath, and they're just gonna be like, ay, 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 ay. Wow. Holy smokes. I guess I'm gonna take Sniper here. Yeah. And then we can go Grafted Growth into Sniper if we want to, or we could just slam the Oath. If they don't equip the Rabbit Battery, we're definitely gonna kill it. Okay, maybe they hit me for 4 haste here, that's not bad. Season of Renewal. Probably want that one. Actually, how do we... I think we want the land first, then the season. I'm a little bit worried about, like, Ryu. It's pretty good, too. So we want to triple block the boar here, I think, is the game plan. We don't take any trample that way. They only trade for 2 of the 2/2s. I only take 4 damage. Okay, let's go ahead and... Growth. Pump up our Vigilance creature and play the Behold. I'm going to play it a little bit conservatively now since we're going to draw a bunch of new cards. Let's not attack with both this time. Sure. Don't need those, obviously. Shrine Steward grabs another Grafted Growth. But how do we want to play this turn? I think we're going to start off by shooting their 2/2. Which allows us to attack for 3. And then we'll just play the Puzzle Maker afterwards. Get some more good defensive creatures on board. We're about to flip our Behold the Unspeakable too. I guess we're just looking for like Geothermal Kami at this point. Gain 3 life, reset the Behold. Alright, nice, they gave up. Like I said, our hand was pretty well crafted to beat an aggressive deck, so... Glad we drew well. Nice little 3-0 start. See if we can keep running it up. Oh, another fast match. Alright, maybe I'm not going to edit out the video. Which means there's going to be that one match where I kind of turned away for like a minute and just didn't say anything. But you know what? That's fine. It's fine. Another decent hand here if the opponent's playing an aggressive deck. They are playing Ninja. And yeah. Our 3-3 into our 1-4 is one of the better creature interactive curves you can have versus ninjas. 3-3 blocks everything early, 1-4 blocks everything. And we just want to buy time to the late game, obviously. Snap attack, or rather snap blocking if they attack. Always, always. Sure. You know, if you thought a 3-3 with reach was good, how about a 1-4 with flying? You beat that. They're gonna pump, and I will block. Do you have a land? They don't even have a land. That's unfortunate for them. Lose out on some value. Ooh, we have the combo now. Let's go Grafted. Play out the Puzzle Maker. And then I think we're just going to pass now, right? Oh, they're still pumping. Okay, that's a little bit concerning. Obviously, if I play a Containment Construct, they just kill it with the Life of Toshiro, so I can't do that. I mean, I'm going to block if they attack. But that's a little bit concerning. Oh, maybe they just messed up. Alright. Turns out they messed up. Now we go combo. Construct. Modern Age. Discard land. Play the land for free. Bingo, bango, bongo. Pass the turn on them. Oh, they might attack with both here, trying to get a ninja in. Try to deny me value with the construct. Nope. All right. I'm snap blocking here. I think they just want to draw a card. Sure, they could have you already dead, but we have the season renewal, so it doesn't really matter. It looks like they just bricked again. Oh, hello. 2, 4, 6. Hello. When the opponent's mana screwed? Yeah, that's going to be a hard one to beat. Now we're going to wait one more turn. Alright, whenever I cast an artifact, instant, or sorcery. I mean, yeah, they got mana screwed, so. Jin Gataxius, hello, hello. 4-0, let's go, baby. Feeling good. Feeling good, finding matches quickly, too? Man, that's a good sign. More and more people entering Diamond and Mythic, so I don't have to wait around forever. How's our hand look? A little bit weak. Just as in, I don't really have... Again, this deck doesn't really have much early removal, so... You do want to... Like, I do need to have some early plays. Okay, this is turning out nicely, though. Yeah, turn two construct, turn three grafted, turn four a five drop. Black-white automaton. You do not see that very frequently. Although black-white does have a lot of the... artifact and enchantment matters cards. So, I guess that could be what's going on over there. I guess if they attack with the automaton now, assuming it pumps to a 2-2, I'll trade. I probably should have traded last turn. Okay. You got me. So I take four. That was a very good draw. I can't play that next turn unless I draw an untapped land, though. Whoa! Whoa. Well, that's not bad. We got rid of five lands. And we did gain life there instead, but holy smokes. We'll discard a Terrarium. Nice. We don't need any of these. And I guess we even get to start attacking, huh? Sure. Well, they have yet to play any artifacts for that Patchwork Automaton. Now, that means... doesn't mean necessarily they're... what the heck? I'm gonna say, doesn't necessarily mean anything, but... I have one creature in my graveyard. So we'd be trading this for their Blade Blesser, I guess? That's fine. Rather trade that away than my Tanuki, right? Also, we have good recursion if we can find our season or whatever. Yeah, they drew an O-ring. That was a good draw. Go ahead. I mean, I don't really want to shuffle because we have... oh, man. Shuffling's actually really, really bad. We have these, which we don't really want to draw, and we also have five lands put there from the... yeah, we're declining here. Five lands from the Blossom Prancer. So we, like, if I did go grab this Grafted Growth, we'd effectively be shuffling five lands back, six lands back in the deck, which we don't want to draw, clearly. Alright, they have a clock now. That Inkrai's Infiltrator will start smashing me. It's only three damage, I guess, if they pump. Can you draw a land, please? Interesting. Okay, well... yeah, that's fine. Oh, a turn off! Although that does mean I get to smash out now. I'm not in great shape though. If they keep ripping spells. I will double block that. I'm hoping they're just pumping their Inkrai's here. Okay, good. Back to confident. I don't think they should have attacked with their 0-4. I think that was a bad attack. We do have an artifact and an enchantment. We're gonna keep one land in our hand in case they draw like a Virus Beetle or something. We don't need to play it out right now. Pick four, yeah. Six. Woo! And then we drew the nuts. Alright, so... 3, 6, 7, 8. I assume they're going to be chumping here. Now we go land. Behold, and Life of Toshiro gained 2 life. Easy freaking money, baby. Let's go. That ain't good enough. I get to draw 4 cards here and gain 2 more life. Oh, actually is... yeah. Not freaking bad. Pew pew your flyer. That should do her. They don't die, but they have to trade. And in fact, we can Kappa back our Kami, kill the touch, get back our Tanuki. Hello, nurse. Yeah, let's go. Looked a little bit dicey there for a brief moment, and then we drew well. And the biggest part of that game was choosing not to go grab that grafted growth with our Shrine Steward. Shuffling 5-6 lands back on top would have been not necessarily on top, but off of the bottom, which means they have, you know, greater chances of being somewhere near the top since they're all on the bottom. So, I don't remember those things. Now, I don't think I'm talking out of my butt, right? It was Blossom Prancer and then the Imperial Oath Scry, right? I didn't shuffle in between or something. I think so. Anyway. Put me on the play, coach. This hand's close. I think it's a keep. The Modern Age does so much work at filtering this kind of draw. Obviously, this hand is bad, but the Modern Age makes it good in a sense, if that makes sense. Also, drawing Terrarium made it good, so clearly I'm the best ever. Yeah, let's go Terrarium here and go grab a green source then. Sad that I have to grab green since we have so much green in our deck, but I think just playing out the Grove Archer is going to be correct. Oh, getting the Modern Age online is also really good. Are they going to hack me? Or Prosperous Thief me? Okay. I hope I draw a swamp soon. 0 mana, Eater of Virtue. Yikes. We do have the Construct plus the Age combo, but the opponent, well, we have a problem. Okay, well, I guess I'm taking 6 and they get to loot. Could all have been avoided if I was on the play. Yikes. So I guess we're hoping to draw a swamp or sniper. Yeah, it's looking bleak. I wonder if the real mistake I made was just not slamming the Modern Age on turn 2. The sooner that Modern Age flipped, the safer we were going to be, right? And that also would have given me a little bit more information on what I wanted to grab with Terrarium. But I really wanted to play the Grove Archer ASAP. Ah. Yeah, their draw has just been incredible. Good stuff. So we'll block here, it'll take 2, 3, 7, 8, 9, they get to loot again. That's not awful. Dang it. Really need to find something there, though. Ugh. Network terminal there, for example, would have been insane. Still dead them playing a creature. Hard to beat that draw, though. Without removal in your deck. Where are you? This is the punish right here. Not grabbing Swamp with the Terrarium. Yeah, I think I just messed this game up. I should have played Modern Age on turn 2. We have so many green sources in this deck. Well, if they don't have a land, we're not dead, I guess. So they're gonna move the Eater of Virtue. Okay. So this forces me to block the Disruptor then. Mm-hmm. So that's a forced block. I get a flyer next turn, but they have two flyer. Well, they're gonna have three flyers is the issue. Yeah, I don't think we have any out. I guess I could draw Blossom Prancer and gain 4 life. No, that would be an out. Blossom Prancer. That is not a Blossom Prancer. Alright, GG's. Yeah, I messed that game up for sure. Playing that Terrarium on turn 2 instead of playing out the, the Modern Age, I think, cost me. Yeah, for sure. So instead go turn 2 Modern Age, see what you loot into, and then you get another loot on the next turn as well, so you're effectively looking 3 cards deep for any land, and like, if I hit a forest, then I can play the forest Bamboo Grove Archer on 3 anyways, and remember we have more green sources than anything else. Then on turn 4, I go Terrarium, grab a Swamp, Life of Toshiro, and I think if I do that, we're actually pretty stable. I don't even think that's hindsight. I think that was just a bad play by me. Ah, so we're once again on the draw. Man, turn 2 Kappa is really tempted to keep. I think we can do better though. Oh, wow. Nope, I lied. We can't. I'm going to keep this and hope to draw a blue source. I don't think going to 5 is correct, but that sucks. Yikes. Wow. This is just a worse hand than our previous. It's not what we wanted. Island off the top. Let's go. Come on. Ooh, saved. Okay, now we have a chance. Now we have an actual chance here. Even fixes our other colors now. This is just equip and attack. We are jumping for joy. Oh, fantastic. Jumping for joy indeed. So let's pitch the... I guess I'm gonna pitch the Kami of Terrible Secrets and not get greedy. Like, I know I can cast off the Grafted Growth, but I think keeping the lands is the right choice. How good is playing Forest Island Plains and then discarding a Kami of Terrible Secrets? So what's the plan then? Next turn, our Modern Age is going to flip. We get to Grafted Growth. Pump up one of our flyers. And then ideally cast Imperial Oath on turn 5. Earn 5 Oath would be real good. Okay, well they didn't do anything last turn with 3 mana, so... This is a free roll attack for them. This is just a snap block. Oh, I guess they're gonna plan on shooting my Modern Age is what they're doing then. Makes sense. And I think I like attacking and scrying next turn, or scrying this turn. I don't really care if they shoot the glider and then attack me for 2, that's not a big deal. Yeah, whatever. Nope, don't need that. It's nice for the looting, but we don't need it for the mana. I'd rather just find action at this point, since next turn we're casting our lovely Imperial Oath. That's a problematic card for us. Ooh, yeah baby, let's go. Is this just a triple bottom? Oh, I guess I should have attacked for 1 first? Yeah, I should have attacked for 1 first. 2, 4, 6. Bottom 2. So our game plan is to behold, neuter their team, draw 2 cards, and then Kami back the behold. While they're going to be drawing a bunch of cards. We do get to attack here, which is pretty sweet. Because they can block one of the 2/2s with their Leech Gauntlet and gain 1 life, but they're not going to block the other 2, which means they take 4. So effectively taking 3 from the unblocked ones here. But yeah, that guide bot's going to keep them in the game. Hopefully we can find Jin Gataxius in time. Well, I say in time, we are beating them right now. Tales of Master Sashiro. Alright, I like that. Now it only costs 1 mana for them to activate their guide bot. Safekeeping's good. Definitely. Actually, if I keep one of the growths, we can attack into the Leech Gauntlet. Oh, they just pump it again next turn, so never mind. We don't want those. Okay. Two, four, six, eight. Oh, that is a large card. Okay. Tap land, a little bit unfortunate. That doesn't, or that means I don't get to immediately recast Vision this turn. That's a decent draw. Actually, drawing the Kappa means I think we don't play out the geothermal anymore. Ooh, in fact, we might want to go Hellbent here instead. Well, let's see. Kappa's 2, 5. No, it's green, 1, 2. Geothermal, bounce the grafted. One, two, three, four, five, six. I guess we'll just wait. All right. They've got a big board. Yeah. Okay. I think I'm just gonna ship everything in front of the skyscraper and let them hit me for 5. I don't think we use our safekeeping here. I think we just let this happen. We need to save the safekeeping for our vision or for our Kappa. We're going to attack with our vision next turn. I don't think I want to attack with my flyer anymore. Yeah, so attack with the vision. Bounce it back with Kappa. Kill their Tawashi guide bot. And then replay Behold. Pass again. And then we can set up for rebuying the Behold once again after this. That was the important thing, getting rid of their Tawashi. Now their other creatures don't really matter. Nope. We protect it. Fantastic. Nice. All right, now we're looking really good. Their creatures are fat, though. Guess we don't need any of those. Gotta find, like, Gataxius or something. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 mana. 10 mana. So we can go Tanuki plus Kami, I guess. I'm gonna cast Behold the Unspeakable like 4 times and still lose this game. Easy double block with a 4-3 and a 1-3 here. And if they want to use a removal spell to clear the way, I am A-okay with that. Otherwise, they're just trading for one of my smaller creatures, so that was a really good trade for us. Oh, wait. We saw... I didn't realize Jin Gataxius we knew about. Actually, we know the order of the majority of our deck here. Let's see. Can I attack with this? If I make it an 8-7, Yeah, let's... go like this. Man, this is where that Raito Sentinel would be really good. That is a great card to draw, because in conjunction with the Life of Toshiro, we can kill their Bearer of Memory even if they pump it once. Reach creature. Ooh, drawing another shrine. Well, that's not. They can start picking off my two toughness. I mean, that's not the worst case scenario. Aha. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay. Okay. So now we get to Blossom Prancer. Grab our Gataxius. Oh, I can't cast it this turn. I thought I could cast it. Oh, whoopsies. Attack, attack. Oh, they're blocking with their Bearer of Memory. Oh. Well, I guess I could save my Tanuki here. Okay. Sure. This is a crazy game. They have five cards in their hand still, my god. It is a very large green shrine. Ooh, Death Touch. Okay. Yeah. I don't think I need to block with anything else. I'm blocking with the Kappa, so the Kappa goes to the graveyard. Oh, they're letting this happen. Oh, hell yeah. Interesting. I don't think they should have done that necessarily. Okay. So we can get back our Twin Shot Sniper and our Geothermal. No, Twin Shot Sniper and Aspen Enchantment. Twinshot Sniper kills both of those. All right. Wait. Oh my god, Season of Renewal with Jin Gataxius. Wait, I can double that. Never mind. Artifact, instant, or sorcery, yeah. So let's copy that. For two and scry. They can just block with the Blossom Prancer, I realize. Okay. Go from there. This is a crazy game, bro. 8 cards left in my deck. That Sentinel would have been so good, too. What a grind. Okay. Sure. They might just scoop to the Season of Renewal. Wait, what are they splashing white for? Maybe just a white shrine or something. Okay, that doesn't matter. Alright, then we're going to go ahead and double up. So let's return a creature. And enchantments. And that's gonna copy. And then we can return a creature and enchantment. Oh, whoops, I meant to get the bamboo. Doesn't matter, I guess. Because now this Twin Shot Sniper is gonna copy itself. Gonna shoot the Blossom Prancer twice. Going to load up our Puzzle Maker, I guess. And put him on a pretty fast clock. Oh, I can't play out the other one. I guess just pass? I don't know. Well, that could be the bait spell, and now they cast something. Nope, that's not it. Can I attack with everything and kill them? Does that work? They're effectively at 10 because of the Leech Gauntlet, though. Six cards left in my deck. Alright. They gave it up. Good. I didn't have to do the math. I didn't have to figure it out. Crazy, crazy freaking games. Is that 5 wins or 6 wins? I hope that's 6, because this is another long, grindy game. Okay, whoop! One more. Hopefully this is the final boss. 6-1. Only lost to that, what was it? It was like a super curve-out deck where we were on the draw. It was the artifact deck, right? Yeah. Let's see. How many games have we been on the draw with this deck? Details. We've been on the draw the last 5 games. Yikes. We are on the play for the first 2 games. We've been on the draw for the last 5. Okay, here we go. Final boss time, hopefully. Put me on the play, coach. Coach, what are you doing? Please, coach. Please. We've lost all of the last 6 die rolls, 7 die rolls. What did I say? I don't even remember now. Hand's pretty good, though. We have a castable Life of Toshiro. We have a Terrarium as well. Sadly, I cannot kill that one. Looks like we're wanting to grab blue here, I guess. Because Modern Age comes down early, and then we have the Tanuki, which can go grab a different color. On the draw versus ninjas is not great. I will say that. Wow, main fit. That is aggressive. Holy smokes. I guess I'm just gonna pass and. I mean, I wanna grab a. Plains with the Tanuki, but I think I'm supposed to grab a forest so I can Blossom Prancer next turn. That suit up was. Another play I can make is run out Life of Toshiro. Gain 2 life with the trigger. Then on the following turn, it triggers. Give creature -1/-1. Bounce it with the Kami and replay it if I can get to 6. That was a very aggressive suit up, though. Uh-oh. OP. Network terminal. I do not mind seeing that. Okay, no ninjas, good. I know I'm going to get punished by grabbing a green source by probably drawing another forest immediately, but I think it's the right play. It's not a bad draw. Alright, that'll work. I think gaining 4 there was a decent play as well. But growth lets us do some nonsense. So now next turn, we can go grafted growth, plus Life of Toshiro, and then make the play I was talking about. Shrink their infiltrator, bounce it with the Kami, shrink it again and kill it. We're really hoping here that they don't kill my Blossom Prancer though. Because if they can't kill Blossom Prancer, then we're in a really good position. Where we get to growth, into life, into hold open safekeeping for any nonsense. Nope, scratch that. Oh, and scratch the play where we get to kill it with Life of Toshiro now too. Not great. It's not a bad draw. I suppose. I mean, it doesn't block yet. But if I use the Terrarium and turn it into a 2/5, then even if they pump the Infiltrator once, it doesn't attack through. I'm still wondering why they used that suit up. Let's see it. Oh, that's fine. That ain't no ninjutsu. I can deal with that. Make us both sack a creature, huh? Alright, that's a little more annoying, I suppose. Interesting. I guess I'm just gonna Oath and get the Scries in. Oh man, Gataxius not even good here. Brutal. Brutal, brutal, brutal. We have a second Blossom Prancer in this deck, right? Oh, am I just crazy? We only have one Blossom Prancer. Okay. We found a target for our Life of Toshiro. Yeah, they're gonna loot with the construct, get the free card. Play it and maybe hit me for 4? Well, I don't care about that, whatever. I think that's better than them hitting me for 4. So swing with both. Kappa. Kill their Twisted Embrace. Life of Toshiro. Kill their Containment Construct. Modern Age. Discard Island. Play Forest. And now we're looking pretty good. Now that I killed their Twisted Escape, I can make that play I was talking about much earlier, where I Life of Toshiro, their Infiltrator, then bounce the life with the Kami. Yep, so I'm going to be at 2, but then I'm going to be heavily favored on board. Oh, right. Go back up to 5. I lied. Right. Got him! Let's go, baby. What a swing. What a damn swing. Sadly, though, our boy Jin Gataxi- No! They have a second?! Yay, yay. Rude. Alright, well, that's not bad. At least it buys me another turn of air blocking. Doesn't do me anything to put a 1-1 counter on one of these, right? Because I can pump that up to a 5-6. Yeah. I mean, the good thing is, if they attack with the Infiltrator, we block with the Puzzle Maker, and they're forced to double pump, which eats up their entire turn. So I still think we're looking pretty decent here. And in fact, I'm probably just going to fire off the safekeeping if they do that. They attack, I block with Puzzle, they pump, I safekeeping, I time walk them. Seems like a great play. They have flooded out a bit, haven't they? 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, they flooded for sure. Ah. Wait, why tap that one though? Because now they have to double... I mean, I'm snap blocking. Let's go. I guess they didn't want to give me a scry. Pretty good draw there. Up our construct. Might as well gain an extra life. All right, your move. I'm letting them ninjutsu if they want to, but I can't really see a way where letting one creature ninjutsu me could... I mean, I guess if they have a hacker and then they draw into Behold? But that doesn't even win, that just... I mean, this doesn't matter. Sure. They only have one card left, so. And that certainly ain't gonna cut it. Hey, let's go, baby! Whoosh, whoosh, whoosh. All right. Worked our way up from, I don't remember where we started, but up back up to number 3. Again, I did hit number 1 earlier today on stream, but yeah, nice little one there. 7-1 with little Jin Gataxius. Only lost versus some aggro deck of some variety, and we ended up losing like we lost 7 of 8 rolls, or 6 of 8 rolls or something, die rolls, but yeah, some really good blockers. Puzzle Maker did some MVP work. Life of Toshiro, always fantastic. Even got to cast the Jin Gataxius a couple times. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Hit that like and subscribe button. Hopefully you've been enjoying these drafts, because these last couple have been great. We'll see you back next time. Peace out.